Congratulations on breaking the box office record. That's a pretty special thing. I think the question fans have is, are you guys really going to walk away from Marvel? Because you've been such a huge part in guiding that into the amazing thing that it has now become.
Look, the work we've done with Marvel is among the best work we've ever done in our lives. We're very proud of it. We're very grateful for it. And our partnership, our collaboration with Marvel Studios has been amazing. Everyone there is so talented and so exciting for us to work with. I mean, I'm sure at some point we will collaborate with them again, but our job on Endgame was to really bring a sense of closure to what we've known as the MCU up until this point. And I think it was very important for Joe and I to only be thinking about the road that we've all traveled with the MCU up until this moment in time and not thinking about the future. It was very creatively liberating for Joe and I for the first time in 7 years after 4 Marvel movies to not be thinking about the future of where Marvel storytelling can go, but simply be thinking about how do we give audiences and ourselves the most satisfying conclusion to the story. And so I think it was very important that we did that, and we sort of separated ourselves from where the future would go, at least for the time being.
I'm curious, as the people who finally brought Spider-Man into the MCU with the amazing Tom Holland, how do you feel about that situation, which seems to be a little bit more complex than it was when you guys had
Well, I'll say this, it was extremely difficult for us to be able to reintroduce the character of Spider-Man in Civil War and find a way for Sony and Disney to partner on that. And all credit to Kevin Feige, the head of Marvel Studios, for being able to pull off a very difficult marriage of two big Hollywood studios who are basically competitors of one another. But they were able to find a way to share that character for those films. And Joe and I are very, very grateful for the opportunity to have made movies with that character and to have relaunched that character. But we knew it was a difficult marriage. It's hard to get two big studios to cooperate with one another. So the fact that the marriage is falling apart, frankly, isn't that surprising to us, even though it's sad for fans. But I just have to look back and say that I'm very, very grateful for the opportunity that we had with the character.
You talked to us a bit about how excited you are to be working with Chadwick. I know your company's supporting him in his future endeavor.
Yes, and that, by the way, 21 Bridges is the other script of ours that Matt Carnahan wrote on. So we're very proud of the work that Matt contributed to 21 Bridges as well. But yes, Chadwick is one of the most amazing actors we've ever worked with. We're so proud to be able to introduce that character of Black Panther to the MCU and cast Chadwick in that role. And our collaboration with him has been amazing. So the fact that we can move forward now with him and sort of find another way to celebrate him as a fantastic leading actor. I mean, 21 Bridges is a really exciting story for my brother and I. We've always been a fan of like the classic New York City cop films, Sidney Lumet movies, and this is 21 Bridges is in that tradition. It's a sort of a classic New York City police corruption story, but with very, very modern themes and sensibilities, and it speaks, I think, very poignantly to a lot of very complicated things that are happening today.
We love you, 3001.
Oh, that's really cool. That's beautiful.